feeds back up. It should be up just in just a second. Alrighty, we are back. So, I'm just gonna check out the map real quick, see if there's any bubbles around, stuff that we can go kill. Looks like 6 Charlie's really busy, so we'll head over there. Alrighty, destinations and fleet. Go ahead and undock and get to the 5F gate. Hopefully none of my friends kill you.
They probably will. Fuck them. You know how I roll.
It looks like there's nobody in station, so you're outside of station.
Wait, which gate was that?
5F. Alrighty, so we'll get to the 5F gate.
Warp drive active.
So I am flying a shield thorax. It's 5 ion blasters in the highs, warp disruptor, 2 named large shield extenders, large FS9s, medium or a Tenemen experimental micro warp drive, damage control, 2 gyros or 2 mag stabs and 2 tracking enhancers. I've got a medium anti-EM screen reinforcer, 2 medium core defense field extenders, and I. Gate. Hopefully no one
can I just
you.
Jump through? Because I think they're going to kill me.
Yeah, you all, they just jumped through, so you're safe for a second. Hold on just a moment. Alrighty, go ahead and jump and hold your cloak. So it looks like my alliance mates, since we're just leaving my home, are looking to go on a small gang roam. Danny, go ahead and warp to 8V.
Warp drive active.
So, Danny, you'll be warping to 8V, and then from there we'll be going K5. I don't know if your autopilot's looking the right way yet. I mute my Skype, it's probably driving people crazy.
Some of your alliance mates are in warp with me.
Fantastic. Alrighty, so hold for just a second. So basically what we did was we just looked at the map. We see that 6 Charlie right here has got 13 kills in the last hour. So most likely there's some activity going on there. Alrighty, you can go ahead and jump and warp K5. So I am flying with Lynx here, but really, like, the biggest reason I'm flying with said Lynx is because I don't want us to just go, you know, 20 jumps and then jump into a gate camp and die, so I'm trying to see what we jump into before we jump into it. So basically the idea behind this thorax is it's really fast. It's got decent damage projection, so with Null I have 7k optimal and 18k falloff. Drones, I'm running 2 sets of lights. I'm running Warriors and EC300s. That way I can just choose depending on the situation I'm in. Danny is flying an armor tanked Vexer. It's, I believe, probably 5 Electrons. Micro warp drive, long point, double web. No, it's a scram on that one. And then 1600 plate, 2 EANMs, damage control, and a drone damage amplifier with probably just Trimarks and maybe 1 anti-explosive. Basically, my ship is fast and agile. Hers is more tanky and does a better job at keeping people pinned down. Alrighty, Danny, go ahead and jump.
Warp drive active.
some reason my autopilot's all sorts of screwy on Fat Cat.
Warp drive active.
There we go, got it fixed.
Yeah, mine seems to be good. I know in some systems, the autopilots, like your autopilots can show up differently in some regions of space. Even though you're in the same system and going the same way, there are a couple spots in what? There are a couple spots up north that do that too.
That do what?
Your autopilot, like for different people, will show up differently. The path, the routes will show differently.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there's actually a split in Syndicate that's like that, but once you know the area, it's pretty easy to avoid. Alrighty, so go ahead and advance on contact. Moving pretty quick, nothing in space so far. Alrighty, so in FD, we have five pilots, we have a Myrmidon and a Cyclone on scan. The Myrmidon's on short scan. Cyclone's on long scan. So I'm probably going to... We just went minus one. Myrmidon jumped out into PF. We're going to go check out PF real quick, see if maybe we can get... We can take that fight as long as we get them split up, but two cruisers against two battlecruisers isn't super easy.
Well, the challenge might not be bad. Something interesting for the viewers to watch. Now, when you're, how do you judge when you want to engage and when you want to back off?
Usually, can I get some kills? I'll engage. If I can't get some kills, I'll back off. Okay, so the Myrmidon is in PF. Scan in here has just the Myrmidon. The Myrmidon's at a tactical. I'm going to... Let's see. I'm going to warp links to a safe. Go ahead, Danny, and jump into FD and warp to the PF gate.
Warp drive active.
In warp?
Alrighty, the Myrmidon warps off.
Who is that Myrmidon? Because these four are blue to me in FD.
Yeah, I didn't catch his name. Let me see if any of them. There's one Cass. There's one... Different guy. There's one goon swarm. Let's see, so there's one goon swarm in here. My luck, it'll be the Myrmidon, and I'll have to solo him. Alrighty, Danny, so go ahead and hold on this gate. And just watch your scan. If anything comes on scan, let me know. If anything lands on grid, let me know.
Oh, yes, of course.
So, guys, now since scan and grid is clear in here, I'm just going to warp to the Orval gate, which is really the only other thing of note in this entire system, and we'll see what's over there. And I'll tell you if it's a Goon Swarm Myrmidon or not. Nothing on scan at the outgate. Interesting. What do you have going on in there?
I have a just a wreck of a cruiser, but nope, nothing. No activity. No ships on scan, rather.
Warp drive.
So you'll want to notice that I always warp to tacticals. In systems like this that are usually heavily bubble camped, I like to always warp to tacticals because that allows me to choose my positioning on grid, but if I warp to a bubble, then it's them choosing where I land. Myrmidon and Dominix on scan halfway through the system. With some pause trash. Nothing at scan at the outgate. Okay. The warp links back to FD, and we'll see if we can find that cyclone. If not, we'll keep moving.
Warp drive active.
Ruat wants to know, okay, so at 360 degrees, how do you tell what direction they are in?
You don't. You have to narrow down from there. So, for instance, I'm at 360, I have a mobile warp disruptor and a Glente control tower. Go down to 180, and I lose the Glente control tower. So I know it's behind me somewhere. And there, it's back on now, and then I can narrow it down from there. We're at 90, and then 60. So use tracking usually helps when you do this type of stuff. So we can look over towards that cluster. It's not there.
Cyclones on directional.
Okay. See if you can narrow them down at all. I'm horrible at scanning, by the way, but that's the idea. You basically just change it down from there. 360 just tells you what's around you. It doesn't tell you a direction.
It appears he's most likely at a. He's in the direction of both the station, in the cluster that has both the stations.
Okay, most likely he's on bottom station. I'm just going to warp the links over to XB real quick, and then I will go check it out.
But, well, see, that's the thing. I think he's actually at a safe because both of those stations are 13 AU, which means they're outside of my scan range.
Nope. Scan range is about 14.7, I believe.
Oh, okay.
So I'm warping to the station at 30. I don't want to
Nope,
warp.
he's on gate. Oh, no, that's you. Sorry.
It's
Never
me.
mind.
So I'm warping to the station at 30 because, again, I want to dictate my own range on him. And if I go at zero, I have less of an opportunity to maneuver. So if I wasn't lazy, I would have been scanning on the way over here to see if he was indeed here, but I'm lazy, so yeah.
Now, Ruact was saying, "Oh, I used a slow scan. I used a slow scan number." And no, really, you want to start wide and then close down.
So Cyclone apparently looks to be at this other station. He is at a 30 degree to there, so I'll warp there.
Warp drive.
So it is a goon cyclone, so I have to leave him alone because Danny can't help me with the fight.
Yeah.
Looking at him, he's fit with missile launchers, they appear to be hams. So it's a fight that I would lose 1v1, so I will just go to XB, although it looks like he wants to fight. Makes me sad that I can't fight him.
Warp drive active.
I will meet you
Danny?
at XB.
Yep, go ahead and warp
Yes.
to XB. XP's empty, we will move on to Poitot.
Warp drive.
Fucking goons, man, they're everywhere.
I know. They're like roaches or syphilis.
Yeah. Drives me fucking nuts.
Me too. Ah. And no, Asher, I'm not gonna let you DD me. You can't DD me. I don't have a cap.
Go ahead and advance.
Now, some people, as they're watching, you are using the tactical display. So explain a little bit why you choose to use the tactical display.
Well, anymore, it's just because like I feel naked without it, but it helps me judge just by pixels, no matter how zoomed in or out I am, how far people are away from me. And for me, it just helps with grid management as far as how close people are, how far they are away, where they are in relation to me, above or below the plane, stuff like that. Go ahead and advance, Danny. It's something that was a bit hard to get used to, but after a while, it feels so second nature.
Warp drive active.
And a lot of times, I'll play zoomed out, way zoomed out like I am now, just because I need to see so much of what's on the grid at one time. Mostly it's just box avoidance, though. I'm this piece in the center, and I'm usually just trying to avoid getting close to all the other boxes.
Do you feel it gives you an advantage in PvP?
If it does, it's not a huge one. I think it gives me an advantage, but other pilots maybe not. I don't know. If it doesn't distract you, then I think that it gives you an advantage. It doesn't distract me personally.
You blew Rurek's mind. He wants to know how you knew all that just by looking at him.
Wanted to know how I knew all of what, but just by looking at it?
The fit of the cyclone.
You can just look at what the turrets look like on the ship, and you can tell what they are. If I had some ships with some activatable modules, I could go into more about particle effects. Just keep moving, Danny, and there's nothing in space.
Okay.
But since I don't, I can't really show you much. When I get back to TX, if you want to learn about particle effects, then I can undock ships, and you guys can take a look at different particle effects, and I'll explain what they look like. There's a couple of easy ones, though. For instance, these are blasters. They're very, there's not really, an accentuated gun barrel, per se, on them. If you see one that has, guns that are spinning, you know that they're more than likely autocannons. And they'll autocannons also have things that look like barrels, but this one doesn't. Damage control doesn't have any actual particle effects, so I can't show you that. Point has a particle effect that I can show you, but if I'm using it, I'll probably be too busy to tell you about it. Just keep moving, Danny.
Thanks.
So that's another thing to point out. You want to take advantage of any opportunity for intel that you can. For instance, looking at the Cyclone, I could tell that he was ham-fit. But Cyclones are pretty easy. They're not a ship that has a lot, a huge diversity in as far as how you fit them. If I saw him running around and he never turned a shield hardener effect on, I would probably guess that he was extra large ancillary booster fit. But that's not something you can just guess about any ship. You have to really know how ships are normally fit to be able to make certain assumptions.
Yeah, and like Suicide Machine TV was saying, generally everyone has a suitcase.
Generally speaking, yes. Every 90% of ships you fly in PvP should have a damage control. Galente ships especially, because I have as much base structure as I have base armor. So just turning that suitcase on gives me 60% resist across that 2,000 armor. There's no other resist module in the game that's as efficient as that.
Now, is that a module? Now, in some, when it comes to whether to use named or T2, should you go, when you're fitting a ship, should you go T2, or are there some times where you should just use the metaphor?
Well, right now this ship has two large FS9 regular shield inductions, which are large shield extenders. Ideally, I'd want Tech 2, but because of fitting reasons, I have to fit T1. So you want to go with best named here. I'm very tight on power grid. I'm really tight on CPU. So usually when you want to go with named, like micro warp drives, you almost always go with named. But on other things, ideally you want to go Tech 2 unless there's a fitting restriction, like CPU or power grid. Another example of when you wouldn't do that used to be, 22 in local, grid and scan is clear. I'm going to go, I'm actually just going to warp to a safe, and then, Danny, why don't you jump in and just hold your cloak, because I want to know how many of these are blue to you, if any. 1600 rolled tungsten plates is something that you wouldn't usually use the Tech 2 version, but since they changed them, it's now worth it to use them. Let me know if any of these are blue. If they're not, just aligned to the rebel air gate. So this is another system that's usually highly bubble camped. Cool. This is another system that's almost always bubble camped, so I'm going to warp directly to a tactical. Watch scan throughout system, although most likely I'll just see a couple link ships. There's almost always like a Loki and a Tengu in here.
Going
ahead and align. Yep, just align. Tengu, Legion, Loki, Myrmidon. Okay. Also a Thanatos on scan. Now I've got the stuff on the gate. Thrasher, Merlin, Harbinger, Caracal. This is good. We can fight this. If we come in at range, we make the frigates burn for us, so they all come in at a staggered. We can keep it usually 2v2 until we get to the end when we'll be able to kill off the bigger ships. Danny, go ahead and... Yep, perfect. Danny, go ahead and warp to me now. Okay, so what I'm seeing here is I've got the Harbinger is 259. He is kind of in line with the gate, but off to the side. Danny, let me know when you're about to land.
Okay. I'm in warp. Which drones should I drop first?
You'll want to drop your warriors first. So, what you're going to do is you're going to, when we get into this fight, we're going to warp to the gate at a range, and then we're going to, at a certain range, probably like 70, we're going to want the Thrashers to come chasing. You're going to want to get a web on both of the Thrashers. If you can manage it, double web on one of them is fine as well. But we need to get them webbed so I can kill them. Okay. After that, we're going to want to kill the Thrashers first, and then the Caracal if we can, then the Merlin, then the Harbinger. But it all depends on what order they come in at, and I'll let you know what to do once you land. Okay, so we're gonna warp. We're gonna warp to the gate at 70. That should give us decent ranges for everything, and then I'll adjust as we go. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Go ahead and warp to the gate at 70.
Warping.
Turn on your damage control, please.
It is on. Like Donkey Kong.
Okay, so we're 61 from Nuk, K-N-U-K, in the Thrasher. Watch for him to start burning out to us. Don't approach. Just passively align towards the sun. So I just want you to double-click towards the sun. Doesn't have to be directly on it. The Thrasher is burning over to the gate. The other Thrasher is sitting still. Okay, I'm going to go in and mess with these guys and hopefully get them out and pull them out towards you, okay? So just come up towards me just a little bit. Okay, we have a Thrasher moving really fast now, so he's probably coming for us. Yep, K-N-U-K. Nope, he just turned back around. Okay. So right now, this is all about grid management, guys. We don't want to get too close, because if they get a scram on us, they can kill us. Danny, not so much. She's heavily tanked. I'm not. So that Harbinger's also moving at a decent speed. So we'll need to watch for him. So right now I'm trying to bait him just by getting separated from my friend, and hopefully they'll come after me. But it does not. These guys are being real pussy. I don't know what that's about. They have a huge numerical advantage. I don't know why they're not trying to fight us.
Here's another Thrasher.
There came that Thrasher. We'll see if he burns out towards us. So you want to be watching velocities here. That Harbinger's moving 1,100 a second, so he's probably shield tanked. We can look at him. He's not running a shield hardener, but he's probably shield tanked. Okay. Now we need to go. Toka. He's coming to get a point on me. Danny, come towards me. So I'm going to get my drones out. He's got me scrammed, but that's okay. As long as Danny gets out here soon, we'll be fine. How close are you, Danny?
I'm 35 from him. I'm trying to get closer. Yep, I turned my NWD on.
Try to get a web on him as soon as you can.
I am.
Watch out for this Harbinger. We'll probably have to pull range. Let me repair some shields before we go back in. Okay, he's down. Burn towards the sun, Danny. Burn towards the sun. Okay, there's a tornado here. Burn. We don't want to be close to this tornado. Are you pointed?
No, I am not.
Okay, warp off, warp off, warp off.
In warp.
Okay, I'm out of point range now, I'm warping. Alright, did you get in warp?
I am in warp.
Okay, they have, I saw Tornado Oracle there, let me see. Let's see, Tornado, Oracle, Thrasher, Merlin, Mauler, Harbinger, Flycatcher, and a couple of Catalysts. Okay. So we can reset and we'll do this again. The Tornado really makes it a no-go for us, though, especially because he was right on, like, pretty damn close. He was going to be hurting a lot. So once you land, I'm going to warp to the station.
There's a warp bubble here.
Yep. Burn, 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 off, burn, off, burn, off. Towards the left, you'll see another Celestial. Do you see it? You see where I'm burning?
We have company.
Yep, warp off, warp off, warp off.
Warp drive active.
Did you get off?
I'm in warp now.
Okay. So that's why you want to land right when we land?
Oh no, I'm scrammed.
Crap, okay. If there's a Thrasher there, try to kill it before you die. So as soon as we land, you want to align off. That way you can warp as soon as, if anybody shows up.
Warp drive active.
Good job getting a web on that, Thrasher. Shit! Were you not aligned to the thing you were tried to warp to, or what?
I thought I was. Well, actually, like, I had just a little bit more in the warp bar, and I would have been gone, but I guess I wasn't aligned quite right.
Okay, well, since you're dead, I'm gonna repair real quick, and then I'll go back to the gate and try to get myself killed.
No! Don't do that!
It's okay. I can probably find a way to get kills there. Okay, apparently I repaired all my heat damage. They've got a decent amount of stuff here. I'm a bit surprised how active they are right now.
Warp drive active.
That's a bad exchange, though.
That's alright. I don't really care. So one thing that I would have done differently there if I was alone was I would have switched from Null to Antimatter because it tracks better. And I really needed the tracking against that Thrasher, but I knew that Danny was going to get a web, so it wasn't a big deal. But I didn't really need it. But that's something that you want to try to do. Okay, so there's an Oracle here, which I could solo, but he's got too many friends for me to do that. Alright, so what I'm going to do, and this is not something you normally want to do, I'm going to warp directly to a wreck. That way they all have a launching point from where they can chase me from. I have a feeling they're watching my stream, but I don't really care. It doesn't bug me. So my biggest goal here is to get about 100k from the Tornado at the least. I need to be a long way from him or else he's going to be able to hurt me pretty badly. Okay, and they have links too, which makes this a lot harder on me. This is one of the things that makes it hard fighting outnumbered when the enemy team also has links.
I have found a flycatcher, Drake, Merlin, another Drake, and a Caracal.
Okay, so now I'm out of point range, but the issue is I've already taken so much damage that it's very unlikely that I'll be able to kill anything. Yep, I have to get out real quick.
And yes, links are very important in PvP.
I don't know why this guy in local's talking shit, it's kind of funny, but okay. Alright, tracking actually fucks me when I'm in a fight. Tracking camera, that is.
Ah, local shit talkers can be fun sometimes. So I'm watching the stream with you on it. Okay, Ruact wants to know what a link is.
Okay, so links or gang link modules increase the effectiveness of different parts of your ship. I'm running Loki links right now, which have... See, shield harmonizing, which increases my shield resistances, interdiction maneuvers, which increases my point range and web range, and rapid deployment, which increases my ship's overall speed.
And there are multiple kinds, there are different kinds of links?
Yes, there are four different types, or, well, yeah, there are four different classes of links. You've got... Armored Warfare, which focuses on armor resistances, rep amount of your local and remote reps, the cap consumption of remote reps. Then there's Info Warfare, which is usually Galente holes, and they do things like, let's see, they increase your sensor strength, which helps you from being jammed. And then they also have ones that increase the effectiveness of damps, stuff like that. The Mimnitar ones are the interdiction ones, which increase speed, point range, and reduce signature radius. And then the Kaldari ones increase shield resistances and the effectiveness of your reps on shield tank ships. Okay, so right here, so I can talk about particle effects. See this wavy shit on this Drake? That is a shield harm, shield resist mod. So I'll see if I can warp here before anybody points me. It's unlikely, but we'll see. Okay, so they're not pointing me. I'm not sure what that's about. Everybody was the same people there, so it's not like they were fighting someone else. But this is kind of what makes it hard. Like, I'm in a small ship that's not super capable, so to try to fight outnumbered when we both have links is really difficult, especially when my damage projection isn't as good as theirs. So if I can project damage better than them, I can sit out farther than them and still put down damage, but there's not much of a chance of me doing that here.
With the Bank AmeriCard Cash Rewards credit card, you can earn 1% cash back on all purchases, 2% cash back on groceries, and 3% cash back on gas. Click the banner to learn more.
So the reason I said that is because it looks like the gang that's my friends that was just here just showed up, and yeah, so we'll see. They just warped right into what could have been one of my fights, but... It looks like it's a relatively small Rote Capel gang, but I'll see what they do. If I can get someone to split off and try to come after me, then that would be ideal. There's a lot of shit here, though. And I need to put links back up.
And a little shout out to Sarah M, who's watching. She just tweeted that she's watching the stream and getting a lot of tips. So I'm very... Makes me even happier to have you on the stream knowing that, you know, people are learning something. And it looks like Ruact is learning something too.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go after this Oracle. It's a really long shot, but he's separated from his friends, which might be too busy to help him. Most likely he won't be fit with a point either. So if things do go poorly, I can just switch to, I can just hopefully warp away, but we'll see. I can kill this Oracle 1v1. Okay, so he's shooting me now, so what I need to do is come at him at even more of an angle, so he can't hopefully get any good hits on me, but I doubt that I'll be able to reduce his tracking when he's 120 away from me. So he stopped shooting me. I don't know what that's about. I don't know if he's trying to bait me into coming closer or what. Yeah, there's no way that I can get close enough to him without dying, so I'm just going to warp to a belt. Now, here's a really bad situation where I just lost all my transversal, so I need to hopefully get out soon or else he'll do a bunch of damage to me, and I did get out. Somebody's already warping in the direction I'm going before I even warp. I don't actually know what my court mates or alliance mates are flying, so that makes it a bit harder. What I can tell is they did not want that fight for some reason. I'm not sure how many times I can go in and out without dying here.
Well, I'm looking at the market around here and trying to find something to hop into.
Such a huge system, the warps are so long.
So do you know why Rogue doesn't want the fight? Have they said anything?
They're pretty far outnumbered.
And this is Rock My RV.
Oh my god. Brett Michaels. Pimp My RV. Accessorized.
Modernized. Is that a thing?
That's a thing.
All new Rock My RV with Brett Michaels. Sundays at 9. Only on Travel Channel. We are summer.
Oh man, Tornado's already on top of me. Why Tornado? There's like no fight here for me. I'm trying to see. Yeah, there's nothing that there's nothing separated.
Warp drive active.
Wow, they multiplied rather quickly too.
Mm-hmm.
Like little piranhas. They get a taste of blood in the water. So would you be able to kite any? And that's, I guess that's what we were trying to do, is kite.
Yes.
Kite them away and get them separated.
Right. That's exactly what we were trying to do. But it's really difficult to do that because they have better damage projection than we do.
That's especially with the Tornado there. I mean, the Tornado really is one of the pinnacle kiting ships in the game.
Yep. They have a Beam Oracle, which, you know, is going to hit to ridiculous ranges. He was shooting me at 130. They've got a Tornado that's AC fit, as far as I can tell from how much damage he puts on me. I mean, I can pretty much 1v1 any ship on that grid, but I can't... when they're spread out so that no matter where I go, the Tornado and the Oracle is going to be able to hit me. I can't kill anything.
That does make it rather difficult. Now, looking at their game with what they have, what would be a good counter to that type of game?
I could fight that whole gang with four Drakes.
Really? Heavy missile launcher, heavy missile launcher drakes?
Yes. I could fight that whole game with four Taloses. I just need more numbers. I need more and sturdier ships. I mean, this ship's got maybe 15k EHP. We got 22k EHP with links. So, I mean, it's not the tankiest ship in the world, to be sure.
No, the cruisers did get a rather good buff, but not that great.
Yeah, they're good at killing other cruisers, but when we're talking like 10 against 1, you can't do much with it. You can if they don't out damage project you. Like, that's the issue. If ever I can shoot them, they can shoot me. If I'm in a Drake, or four Drakes, as I was suggesting earlier, we have enough EHP that we can kill off everything quick enough and they won't be able to burn through us. We might lose one or two, but we can kill their whole gang. Notice all the counters I'm talking about. It's not a, well, they have 10, let's bring 10. It's how can I do this in an eloquent fashion and use my brain as opposed to numbers. That's my biggest thing in Eve, is I don't want to. I never try to beat people by bringing superior numbers. I want to beat people by being smarter, being a better pilot.
A tactical advantage.
No, it's not even a
No.
tactical decision to advantage, because I have no advantages except for I'm a better pilot than you are. Like, that's the advantage that I try to win with every time.
Well, that's a good thing to have. Do you find that PvP that way is more enjoyable?
Absolutely, I wouldn't do it if I found it less. I mean, because
I see.
I make the game a lot harder than it needs to be, just because I want the game to be hard. It's more rewarding to me when I win if the game's hard.
And that makes a lot of sense. Easy mode is rarely any fun.
Now, the real issue is that a lot of times, whenever I fight people and they don't have like an obvious advantage in every way, they'll just try to run from me. So that's super, super annoying. Like, the people almost will almost never fight Rogue Capella on 1-to-1 odds unless it's out of our wheelhouse. Like, sure, Rooks and Kings would fight us 1-to-1 because they'd play their game.
Do you think you could pick any one of the ones off the station, or they'd probably just play docking games, huh?
They'd play docking games, or they'd just be able to kill me before I could kill them.
Now, I see a couple ships, but they're two jumps
Yeah,
away.
just go back to TX, that's where I'm going. I can't
Oh, you're
fight.
already heading back?
Yes, sorry, I didn't tell you. I figured you were watching the stream. I'm
I
heading
am.
I'm heading back home because I want to be able to quit running from even.
What gate is it?
You want to go through 6 Echo.
That's what I thought. Oh, and the guys that were on the station are already gone.
They've been bouncing back and forth between the station and the gate.
Oh, okay.
God, I hate that Eve does this shit. Every time you jump through a gate, it zooms back in on your ship, so you have to zoom back out. It drives me nuts.
It does. I really wish they would make that stationary. I
Another
really
tip,
do.
you can zoom in and out, guys, if you use both left and right click at the same time.
I'm not sure what they're talking about in local.
What are they saying?
They're just going away, way, way in local. Well, they posted a picture. I'm afraid to. It's tiny pixels, most likely pornography.
Well, you can click on it, you're not streaming.
Warp drive active.
Oh no, it is a way, way, way. It's just some dumbass gif. It's not even a good one. Oh, there are some EVE University folks in there.
Yeah, they actually have a small base next door where they're some of them based out of. That's actually where I lost my snake clone last week.
Was it EVE University?
Yes.
Oh, the sneaky bastards.
This venture, he's trolling me and I don't like it.
How is he trolling you?
Well, he was sitting on a bubble when I jumped into MHC, and then I chased him to a, I chased him to a Poco, and then to an asteroid belt. Now he just keeps showing up everywhere I go, but he won't, he keeps running before I can get a point on him. He's trolling me by not letting me kill him.
That is one of the worst trolls in EVE.
Then again, I wouldn't play the game if everybody just let me kill them. That'd be boring.
Yeah, that's true. Sorry I got myself killed in that Vexer.
Oh, it's okay. Did you learn anything?
Align as soon as you land.
Yes.
Which is very important. You should always align as soon as you land. That really should be the first thing you do when you land, is align.
I don't care if you lose a ship as long as you learn something.
You always tell me that, and I still feel bad.
Don't feel bad.
Well, I would really like to be a better PvP-er, but I feel like I keep making...
You do that by making mistakes. You make mistakes, realize the mistakes that you've made. That's the important part, is realizing what the mistake was. And once you've done that, then you can figure out how to fix it, and you'll stop doing it, because it'll be in your head. I just landed, I should align, because we landed on a bubble, which means that they know that we're in a bubble, which means they're going to be chasing us.
That's very true. And it is so true, because I remember, not one of the first PvP-related deaths I've had, but when I first got serious about small game PvP, I was doing bomber warfare, and I learned whenever other bombers are in the system, turn off your micro warp drive.
Yes. Because now, the reason that is, for anybody who doesn't know, is that bombs, the damage a bomb does scales off of your signature radius, and a... micro warp drive gives you a 500% increased signature radius. Where am I? Here I am.
And so it basically makes you a sitting duck.
Yes. This is something I'll also suggest to people. You'll notice I'm flying around without a destination set. The reason I do that is because If I just set destinations everywhere, I don't pay attention to the systems I'm going through, so I never learn routes, and I think it's important to know, like, the geography around you. So a good way to do that is to, whenever you're roaming, whenever you're flying around space, just open up .lan on a second monitor if you have one, or just have it in a window that you can open and minimize whenever, and just looking at the geography around you can a lot of times give you ways to engage or disengage that you wouldn't normally have if you just used autopilot.
I never thought of that. Like, I do rely on autopilot a lot. Sometimes I will, like, I usually only keep EVE maps open when I'm actively hunting. You know what I mean? Like when I'm actively looking for targets. But if I'm just traveling, I'll just rely on the autopilot. And you're right, like there are so many systems, like we were saying, when autopilot gives you different routes, that usually means that there are multiple routes you can take that are the same distances. And if you're, like, say you're chasing and trying to cut someone off, if you're aware of your surroundings, you may know a shortcut. If you, or if you're, same thing, if you're trying to get away, you may know an alternate route to get your direction, or if you know there's a gate camp in the area, you can take an alternate route, you know, and it's so helpful knowing the geography, especially of your home. And I mean, you live in Syndicate, so it's really important to know the geography of your home.
Yeah, and for the most part, I know, there's a few pockets in Syndicate that I don't know, like the back of my hand, but for my normally traveled routes, I know pretty much the whole region and all the connections that it makes.
Alex, visit Hinshaw's Acura.
And see, and speaking of different routes, I see that, I mean, you're going through Placid. I guess I'm, oh no, we are going the same way. Okay.
Right. We could have gone back the way we came or come this way. The major difference is, if I was looking for a fight, I would have gone back the way we came, but I just want to get back to TXW so I can reship and hopefully go fight those guys, which probably won't be on stream, by the way. I have to do that off stream. This is the way that I'm not going to run into any bubbles. It's the same amount of jumps. So there's three ways to get from where we were to TXW that are pretty close in amount of jumps.
And
three complete, like one takes you through Solitude, one takes you through Syndicate, one takes you through Placid. So,
and that is an important thing to note, that when we went, when we were traveling to our destination system, we were going through Nullsec, so there were going to be things like bubbles and all that stuff, but as we're traveling back, we are going through low sec where bubbles are not allowed.
Right, and basically going through 0-0 means I can shoot anything that I see. Zero's low sec isn't the same, because if I shoot things on a gate, I have to be able to kill it before the gate guns kill me, so limits my engagement envelope a bit.
It really does. And on the other side of things, if you're traveling, the gate guns can't protect you. So, you know, if you find someone chasing you, hang out on a gate and orbit the gate, and if they continue to attack you, the gate guns will in turn attack them, and then usually with the combined damage, you can kill them, depending on the situation.
Yeah, like you can, I mean, I'm a pirate, so anybody can shoot me, and I'm not in a pirate like Yar, I believe in low sec. Blah, 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 blah. I'm a pirate in the sense that I shoot things no matter where they are if I think I can kill them. And it's got nothing to do with, you know, like, gate camping. Like, I don't gate camp. It's not something I do, because that's not fighting, usually. If I kill something and it's not a challenge, it's really not that worthwhile for me.
Now, I will admit, I have done a lot of gate camping in my day, and it is. It's a lot of gate camping is a lot of sit and wait. So it's, I found that gate camping is more about the camaraderie in rather than the actual PvP,
which is not a bad thing. Like, I
no, but it's not. But like you said, you know, you're looking for a fight. You're looking for PvP. That's what you're gearing for. And so while it is viable game, it's different. It's not, I don't want to say it's not PvP focused, but in a way it's kind of not. Like, you are PvPing, but that's not what the majority of your time is spent doing, so you can really hardly call it a focus on PvP, you know what I mean?
Well, and it's 99% of the time gate camping isn't challenging. Like, and I'm not going to say that all gate campers are like this, but 90% of the gate campers that I know are going to camp the gate, kill what they can kill, anytime anything resembling a fight, even if the roles were changed and I had their fleet and they had mine, even if I think I could win if I was playing from either side, they won't take the fight unless they have an overwhelming advantage.
There are a lot of gate campers, though, but I can say proudly that in my experience, because most of my gate camping days were with Wrecking Shots, and those guys, like, if we were gate camping, and if in fact, we were gate camping in Uli, and Q-Cats run through that area, and a lot of faction warfare people. And there was, like, for a week, we had regular fleet engagements, because they knew we were there, we knew they were coming, and we were like, all right, we're going to be ready for these bastards this time. And we would, oh, man, it was pretty fun. It's a very different kind of gameplay. I found it, like, more relaxed, while like doing stuff with you is more like I'm sitting on the edge of my seat, I'm really paying attention, like I'm totally cued in kind of stuff.
Yeah, no, and that's kind of the type, like I don't know, I'm like, I would fall asleep gate camping. I mean, if I have interesting people to hang out with, then that's one thing, but I find that, I don't know, there's a lot of people in Eve that, even some people I fly with on a regular basis, that I don't necessarily want to sit next to them and just talk.
Yeah, unless you're doing something like this. Yeah.
If I was drinking, I could see gate camping. But, again, it's not really my gig. But I'm not discouraging anyone from doing it. If you're doing it, that's great. You're out in ships out in ships, out in space, trying to blow shit up. And I'm fine with that. Just, you know, try to fight, dude. Challenge yourself.
Exactly. And it looks like we are back in TXW. Well, I'm back, you're back. And I think we're going to go ahead and yeah, I'm actually talking to Eudorus in-game, and he's saying that you're a good teacher. And I think you are. And I want to thank you for coming on the podcast and coming on and giving the pointers. Because, I mean, I learned something. I'm sure Ruat learned something. It looks like Sarah M. learned something. Eudorus learned something. So, yeah, you're doing the Amarian God's work.
Well, hey, you know, check out my live stream. It's twitch.tv/apatheticbrent, no spaces. You guys can check out the VOD section there. I can be vulgar sometimes, so if you have, you know, slight sensibility issues, then you're probably not going to want to watch my videos. But it's really really instructional, and you can learn a lot from it. And, yeah, I try to stream at least once every couple of days, usually in U.S. Prime. Sometimes closer to EU, but that all just depends. But if you follow me on Twitch, you'll see when I go live. If you follow me on Twitter, I'll start posting on Twitter again when I stream, so you guys can find out. And again, that's at @apatheticbrent. Anywho, thanks for having me on. I am off.
Yes, thank you again. Thank you so much for coming on. And that's it for this episode of Voices from the Void podcast. The podcast, I will get everything highlighted. It will be up on YouTube. And of course, the podcast will be up on the website, www.voicesfromthevoid.net. My Twitter is at Ari Danica. The podcast Twitter is at @VandV_podcast. I also have a in-game chat channel, Voices from the Void, all one word. Or hold on, let me check. Actually, no, it's all separated. So Voices from the Void with spaces. So Voices from the Void, join it, hang out with us. Lord Asher is in there. And that's it for this episode. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you